Okay, the Likutei Maharan, Tegevet Beis. So, we are holding by what Rav Avraham said, how the entire Torah that we learned until now is included in the Maimer of Rav Avraham. So after we explain that the fact that the Lamdan hates and persecutes the Tzaddik and speaks badly of him, this is something which is done purposely from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And the purpose is that the Tzaddik will rectify and elevate the Divrei Torah that the Lamdan learned and distorted them into bad combinations. And the way that it's done, that the Tzaddik elevates the Torah, is when he accepts, first of all, the derision with love, and with this he shines in the Torah Sheba'al Peh that used to be in the mouth of the Lamdan, which is the Shechina, the illumination of the Bina, which is embrace. Then the entire Shechina goes into a state of embrace, and with the Bina. And then, when the Tzaddik is maskil to understand with his Chochma what was the original Torah was before it was distorted by the Lamdan, he's doing with his Chochma. With this, he elevates the Shechina, which is the Torah about Peh, from embrace to kissing. And because now the Shechina is kissing with the Sfas HaChochma. And that prepares the Shechina, who is the Torah Baal Peh, for Yichud with the Netzach Vehod, which is above it. Because even Neshikin is also a Netzach Vehod already, because Neshikin is with the lips, and the lips are the Netzach Vehod of Sfas HaChochma. Once that Neshikin happens, it's called Zivon de Neshikin, it's called the Yichud of Neshikin. It prepares the Shechina for Yichud of the real Netzach Vehod, of bodies, Yichud, Yichud of bodies. And that the Shechina, which is the Torah Sheba'al Peh, is unified with the Tana, the original Tana that originated the Torah. The Tzaddik that learns gives the Shechina what they call Mayim Nukvim, the yearning and the excitement from the Shechina towards the Tana that originated, and that in turn excites the Tana that originated it when it comes together with the Shechina to be mashpia, to bestow upon the Shechina new chidushim, new comprehensions, new understandings, new depths in the Torah that he originally said. And that is called that Shechina ben trei tzadikaya yatvo. The Shechina is sitting between two tzadikim, between the tzadik that illuminated it, that originated it, and the tzaddik that rectify it. It's called tzaddik elyon and tzaddik tachton, the supernal tzaddik that originated it. Tzaddik tachton is now learning, rectified, v'chula v'chula. And it gets perfumed from both sides. It gets perfumed from the tzaddik that rectified it, tzaddik tachton, and it gets perfumed from tzaddik elyon that originated it by being raised to a level of zivo. And all this is included in the Remamar of Rav Avraham Chana. וזה שאמר Rav Avraham Chana. Rav Avraham Chana said, לידידי חזה להורמיס בר ליליסו. I saw that demon, which is called Hormiz, the son of Lilis. דאר קרא את הקופה דשורה דמחוזה, that was running over the teeth of the wall of the town of Mechoza, you know, on top of the walls, they have these like teeth. It was jumping on it. וראה את פרשו כי רחב סוסי המתתוי. And a parsha means a rider, you know, that was riding on a horse, underneath it. It was just galloping, you know, by itself. It didn't do any competition with the demon. But even though the horse was running fast, he could not overtake the demon. The demon was faster. Zimno chado havad masagin letrichi Yusuf. One day they were standing for this demon, two mules with a saddle on top of them. Vekaymin atre gishre de doinam. They were standing on the two mules. Each one was standing on a bridge, or they were standing on two bridges in the river Doinek that were very, very far from one another. It's like the Washington Bridge and the Brooklyn Bridge, you know, the GW Bridge, it's like, you know, they were far. Veshaver behai lehai o mehai lehai, and the demon was skipping from one mule to that mule on the other bridge, from one mule to the. Venakat rekasa dechamer beyadei, and it was holding two grails of wine in its hands. And he would pour them from one to the other, from one goblet to the other. And a drop did not fall down to the earth. And that day, all that was a day, it was a stormy day, that the ships in the sea, you know, were like taken all the way up and thrown all the way down to heaven. And at Kiryochol, they went up to the sky and down to the Hermes. And from the force of the wind, still didn't spill a drop. And the king of the demons heard that this rascal was doing that. And he killed him. Because it's not the derech of a demon to show himself to people. That's why he killed them, because he would reveal their secrets to people. And some say that how were people able to see that demon? Because that demon was an offspring of a man that slept with a sheda, with a female demon, or the other way around. I'm not exactly sure which one it was. The demon slept with a woman, whatever it is. So it was partially human and partially a demon. Yeah. So people could see him. That's one sheeta. There's another sheeta that says that the Caesar, the Caesar of the place, killed him. Not the king of the demons, but the king of the people. That he was afraid that, being that this demon was basically Superman, he was like a superhero, he could do things, so he was afraid he will take his malchus. And he says, Taka, he says, this demon was from a man that slept with a female demon, and he used to live amongst people. This is the original story of Rava Bar Chana. Now, this particular story, this original story holds within it great Torah mysteries, specifically the Torah that we learn now. And this is what it says like this. Ledidi chazele hurmiz. I saw hurmiz. Rashi explained, Perish Rashi, or the Rashbam, Shedhu, he is a demon. This alludes to Tamid Chochem, who is a Jewish demon, because he doesn't learn Torah Lashem Shemayim, but you know, to show off. Bar Lilise, this is Tamid Chochem, Shed Yudaim, this is a Tamid Chochem, who is a Jewish demon. And this alludes to the word Bar Liliso. Bar Liliso, the son of the dark one. Liliso is Shon Laila, Shon night. Because the time when this particular, the female of the Samech Mem, and the wife of the Samech Mem, is called Lilis. That's the female of the Samech Mem. Bar Lilis, as it says in the middle. Lilis is the son of Lilis. Son of Lilis, also here we explain the word Lilis from Shon Laila. Lilis also stems from Shon Laila because its dominion is at night. So he says that Tamid Chochem, the Shed Yudu, he was Bar Lilis. So you know how he became this? Because he learned Gemara. Gemara is at night. The Gemara is called Choshech. He says, "Kamu the Medrash Echidah Moshe ben Yom leLaila kshaya beRakia." How did Moshe know when he was in the Rakia between to tell between day and night? Well, Kodesh Baruch Hu, there's no day and night. Kamu Muvok Shalav Dimo Tir Shabbat Peir. When Kodesh Baruch Hu learned with him, Tir Shabbat Peir. Now, as Gemara Yedashu leLaila, he knew that it was night. The Torah, so we said the Torah about Peh is Abachina of Lilo. Zebar Liliso, the son of Liliso, Nishon Lilo. Lilo alludes to the Torah about Peh, which is Lilo. This is talking about a Lamdan. Sheikah Lamdan, the main thing that makes a Lamdan into a Lamdan, Mitorah about Peh, the Tilas Torah about Peh, you know, from Chumash, a person does not become Tamid Chochem. And he was running on the teeth of the wall. The wall, the choymo, ze tzadikado, the wall is a tzadikado, that protects a generation like a wall. Rebbe says that in Tari Dalad also. The Jewish demon, roidef es tzadikado. He chases the tzaddik adol. Shenim shel lechoymo, that was akin to a war. Kama chazal, as Chazal said in Baba Basra, Tamid Chochem en tzarich nitirus. Tamid Chochem doesn't need a guardian, doesn't need to be guardian. That's why he's potter from paying from guardian. He doesn't have to go to the army either. Ayen shach. So see, Tamid Chochem nim shel lechoymo is he's akin to a Choymo, a wall that protects. He protects himself instead of a choymo. And the fact that the demon was running on the teeth of a choymo means he was persecuting the tzaddik that was akin to choymo, to a tori. V'ra'et parasha. And parasha literally means a rider. Okay? Cavalry. Parashash lefi tumay. You know that innocently, just you know, inadvertently. So what is parasha? You know, al biderech remez. What is parasha? Ze atana shechidesh ze atayra. Uperush ota yafeh. He was mechadish this Torah and he explained it beautifully. Voitzi leot alumon. He revealed something which was concealed before, which was a secret, which was a mystery. And the Tanna revealed it. The Tamid Chochem Sheyudui is persecuting him too. However, Avalafi Tumay. In other words, he doesn't mean to persecute the Tanna. He only means to be right of the Tzaddik, Tzaddik Ado. But the Tanna that he's learning the term, he doesn't mean to persecute him. This is done automatically without him even paying attention to it. The Tamid Chochem does not aim, you know, is not aimed to dispute, you know, to persecute the Tana. This persecution happens by itself. When he was riding on a horse underneath it, it says Kedalamdan. By the fact that he's learning the Torah of the Tana. With this, he returns the nefesh of the Tana to the body of the Tana. that, as we said, you know, when some, when you learn Divrei Torah B'Shem somebody, you are returning his nefesh to his guf, and his lips are kevichol are merachshim in bevavos bekever. You know, that is this being spoken in the kever, and returning the nefesh to the guf is akin to kmo rechivas asus, is like riding a horse. Shasus tfeloi, the sus, this horse, is the not important part. The main part is the rider, right? Same thing, the body is the tofel to the neshama. The neshama rides the body. Vezeh, the Torah says, mitatoi, in other words, that he brought about that the rider was riding the horse from underneath him. That was what Rabbi Khan says. So the question is, okay, so it's with the limud, the neshama of the Tana comes riding the horse. What is the word bitatoy mean? The word that says from below. But in the story, you know, the demon was jumping on the wall and the rider was below. But within the realm of Remez, of Teres Abeinu, what is the fact that mitatoy from below means? What is it? It says, Ki atachtoinim goyim belimudom l'arkiv nefesh atonu al susay al gufoy. Because the lower ones, and the people who are in this world, with their limud, what they are doing is they are bringing about the neshama of the originator of the Dvar Torah that they are learning, to ride on the original body in the kever. Mitatoy means from underneath, from this world, to bring about. The Ruach HaKodesh comes back, you know, the Tanya says, with their limud, when you learn Torah Sheba'al Peh, the Ruach HaKodesh of the Torah Sheba'al Peh, that the Tana was Mechadze originated, comes back to the body of the Tana. And this makes an adherence of Ruach Beruach, the spirit of the person who is learning connects with the Ruach of the Tana. It's as if he's kissing himself, he's kissing the Tana. Aval lo yachilei, but in the story means he couldn't catch up with him. But al pisod lo yachaloi means the Tana lo yachol isbol shikosoi, that the Tana cannot stand kissing himself with the Talmid Chacham shel Yedoi, with the Jewish demon. Because the Nevela is better than him. When the Torah and Shikosoina, and the kissing of somebody that you hate is bad and it's disgusting and it's causing tzar to the Tano. And the Tano is running away from it. So it's considered as if the Talmid Chacham shel Yedoi is actually persecuting the Tano. He causes him to run away. What is persecution? You cause somebody to run away. At Khan for today, not to make it a little too much.